Good afternoon, students. In the last previous classes, we completed the salient features of chondroreactors and osteoarthritis. And also, we studied the differences between chondroreactors and as well as osteoarthritis. Let us see, we'll go for tetrapods. Again, the tetrapods mainly consists of four classes: class Amphibia, class Reptilia, class Eos and Mammalia. So let us see, first one will go on Amphibians, class Amphibians. So if you go for this Amphibians, so it is the first class under tetrapods. So these are the first group of tetrapods. Amphibians are the first members under tetrapods. Okay, so first character was Amphibians, salient features of Amphibians. Amphibians are the first members or first group. Okay, first group of tetrapods are under this class Amphibia. So first group of tetrapods. So these are the first group of tetrapods. Okay, under this class Amphibia. See, tetra means what? Four. Pods means legs. Four legs in the kind of four legs in the four limbs in the kind of first animals. So Amphibians are the first group of tetrapods under. These are the first group of tetrapods. Okay, Amphibians are the first group of tetrapods. Let us see the second category. So these are usually found. These are commonly called Amphibians of the animal kingdom. First category, these are the first group of tetrapods. Amphibians are the first group of tetrapods, and these are also called as Amphibians of the animal kingdom. Amphibians, these are the amphibians of animal kingdom, and these are usually adapting to both aquatic conditions and as well as terrestrial conditions. Hence they are commonly called as amphibians of the animal kingdom. Amphibians of the animal kingdom. It is because they are adopting on both land and as well as there is terrestrial conditions and as well as aquatic conditions. Hence these were generally called as amphibians of the animal kingdom. Let us see the second property. These are usually poikilothermic animals. Poikilothermic animals. Okay, amphibians are poikilothermic animals. Means what? So these are cold-blooded animals. Cold-blooded animals. Okay. So amphibians are the poikilothermic animals. Here poikilothermic animals are cold-blooded animals. Then we will take the skin. You are a skin tone. Okay, the skin is very soft. Skin looks soft. The skin is soft. Slimy. Slimy is jar. Soft is tumba mruvagirutte. Slimy. And even the skin is soft, slimy, and even it is an mucus. Okay. And even you can take the skin is very soft, slimy, okay, mucus, and it is a glandular skin. Glandular skin, and as well as scaleless skin. You are reptilia tone scales varute idralli scales varodilla. So skin tavanagaru, the skin is soft, slimy, moist, very sorry, mucus alla, moist, tumba tevagirthakkanta slimy andre jarodu. Ivaga take an example, frog tagondre neevu frog annu nodi. ಅದರ ಸ್ಕಿನ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಸ್ಲೈಮಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಜಾರು ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, moist andre teva irutte glandular the skin is glandular scaleless and the skin rich with blood vessels the skin is a the skin is rich with the blood vessels jaasti irutte the skin is rich with the blood vessels so that is if you take the skin another one you can take the body the body hoga body if you take the body see observe madili body anta kondaga the body is divisible into head trunk and as well as the tail okay the body is divided the body is divided into head okay trunk and as well as the tail the body is divided into head trunk and tail and so the amphibians mainly consists of two pairs of limbs so here the limbs such as both the fore limbs and as well as hind limbs fore limbs and as well as hind limbs okay the body is divided into head to trunk and as well as tail and the body mainly consists of two pairs of limbs such as fore limbs and as well as hind limbs ivaga fore limbs are very short and hind limbs are very elongated so in such a way the amphibians consists of two pairs of limbs that is fore limbs and as well as hind limbs fore limbs are very short and hind limbs are elongated and they mainly consists of five digits adakke five digits irutte adakke five digits that condition is called as pentadactyl condition anta karidivi so that is if you take the limbs and here usually the hind limbs usually they consists of food is on webbed food jalapara anta karidivi it is very easy for the swimming and as well as swallowing okay and jumping leaping okay so and if you take another one is see and the head is okay triangular in shape and the mouth is present on the head and it is very large the head is large the head is present on the the tip of the terminal portion of the mouth and mouth the mouth is large if you take here the sixth character the head is triangular in shape it consists of large mouth and here it consists of sticky or bifurcated tongue or bifurcated tongue irundirukke the mouth is large and it consists of the bifurcated tongue andre ondra bifurcated tongue see here it is the tongue enadu bifurcation aagirutte like this the tongue is bifurcated tongue or bifurcated tongue anta karidivi or forked tongue anta karidivi and this tongue is or the tongue consists of this tongue consists of sticky surface a tongue tongue mele onta sticky aagirthakkanta on surface irutte so which helps to catch or to hide the insects flying insects very easily it is a this the forked tongue It's very attractive and is it consists of a sticky surface which helps to catch or hold the flying insects very easily. So that is the condition of the mouth. In amphibians, the mouth is present on the surface of the head, and here the mouth is larger and which consists of a forked tongue, bifurcated tongue, bifid tongue, and it is very attractive and it consists of a sticky surface which helps to hold. Or catch the insects or flying insects, okay? And on either side of the body, it consists of a grey color patches were called as tympanium. You are a frog, yeah? Especially in the head portion, on either side of the body, upper head, on either side of the body, it consists of grey color patches. What are grey color patches? Not about you. Okay, if you take the head of the body, so on either side of the body, it mainly comes up to grey colored patches were present. That grey colored patches were called as tympanium. Our tympanium is tympanum or tympanium. So this tympanium, which acts like an ears, but they don't have true ears. They have grey colored patches on either side of the body, which receive the sound vibrations. Sound vibrations are sound signals. So which acts like an ears. So that is the seventh property. Then, if you take heart cover anymore, circulatory system. Heart cover, in amphibians, the heart is three-chambered heart. Amphibians, the heart is a three-chambered heart. It mainly consists of two auricles and one ventricle. Okay, in amphibians, the heart is a three-chambered heart. It mainly consists of two auricles and one ventricle. Here the blood is red in color. And here the RBC cells are nucleated. Here the RBC, RBC cells are nucleated. Nucleus bandirute. Okay, that is the circulatory system in case of amphibians. Let us, we'll take the respiratory system. In amphibians, the respiration mainly takes place by three types. One is cutaneous respiration, and one more is bacular respiration, and another one is the respiration by lungs. Three types of respiration. Cutaneous respiration means cutaneous respiration. Are bacular respiration and respiration occurs by lungs. What is this cutaneous respiration? The respiration occurs by skin. That is the cutaneous respiration. The respiration by buccal cavity or mouth, that is bacular respiration. And the respiration occurs by lungs, pulmonary respiration. Correct. So that is regarding the respiration. Next we will come to another one, is the excretory system. If it is the excretory system, in amphibians, the excretion mainly takes place by a pair of kidneys. Excretory system is very well developed. That mainly takes place by a pair of kidneys. So that we will continue in another class. Thank you.